Well, good morning, Jessica. When disasters like this happen, people say to themselves, well, it's been a year now, so things must be back to normal, but not always. Example is where we are. We're at the Seminole Springs Mobile Home Park here, and you look around, you see space after empty space. 115 of the mobile homes here burned during the Woolsey fire. Nobody has been allowed in this section of the park to move back in. They still haven't rebuilt the infrastructure that was destroyed here. The Woolsey fire was one of the most destructive in the history of LA County. Show you some pictures. It started in Ventura County in the Santa Susana Mountains. It happened because or when Southern California Edison reported a problem with its transmission grid. A couple minutes later, the fire broke out in that same exact spot. 50 to 60 mile an hour winds pushed the flames along. It jumped the 101 freeway near Calabasas. I watched it do that. It burned all the way to Malibu. More than 400 homes were lost. Three people died. 98,000 acres of land burned. Thousands of people, including everybody who lived in the city of Malibu, had to leave their homes for days. It took 2 weeks to contain the fire. Now, 1 year later, hundreds of lawsuits by victims are sort of making their way through the courts. Most of the people who lost their homes are suing Southern California Edison. And even Los Angeles County has a lawsuit against the utility to try and get back some of the money that they had to spend to fight this fire. For this mobile home park, hard to believe, this section of it, nobody's able to rebuild or move back in. And Richard Lohman is one of those people who can't live in a home. It's up there. That's your home there, a new one that you bought. You put it on your space, but you're not allowed to live there. Why not?
Troubles with the state of California, basically.
You can't move in until they rebuild all the sewer lines and the electrical and the gas.
Well, we want to replace everything new before we move the homes back in, but we haven't been able to raise the money to do so. So now we're working on a plan B, maybe where we move the homes back in and fix the existing infrastructure.
How much would it cost to put in the infrastructure that needs to be rebuilt here?
$10 million is the bids that we have.
And this park is owned by the residents. Do they have the money to do it?
No.
You're in this position now, and did you ever think anything like this would happen to you?
No.
I've heard it's been really hard on people who live here. You know, some people have already died, residents here. People had suicide and divorce.
It's been very difficult. This was entry-level housing, and we weren't, you know, well-funded to start out with. The L.A. County helped us buy this park in 1986 and helped us get it. And we, you know, we didn't have catastrophic insurance to be able to cover.
Not enough insurance. Where are you living now, and when are they telling you that you might be able to move into that new mobile home that you had delivered?
Don't know at this time when I'll be able to move into the home. I'm living in an apartment at about three times of what it was costing me to live.
Right. Thanks so much for talking to us. We hope that the situation is resolved very soon.
Yes,
appreciate it.
That makes two of us.
Yeah. A number of people here had insurance money that they were using to cover their temporary rentals elsewhere while this thing is sorted out. But that insurance money, for many of them, or for some of them, is running out. We'll send it back to you.